of the coronavirus pandemic. We now know the CDC had advanced knowledge of the coronavirus pandemic. We know this because the CDC has job listings on its jobs website at cdc.gov. One job listing calls for public health advisors for the quarantine program to help maintain and monitor quarantine centers in Texas, New Jersey, New York, Massachusetts, California, Washington State. While you may think, well, that seems like a normal, obvious response to this outbreak, the truth is that those job listings were posted on November 15th of 2019, before anyone knew about the virus other than Communist China. You see, in November of last year, that's when Communist China was covering it up, but they were ordering scientists to destroy tissue samples, and they were punishing whistleblowers and even arresting doctors who were trying to spread the word about this exploding pandemic that was out of control in Wuhan, China. As that was happening, the CDC was hiring people to train to run quarantine centers all across the United States, focusing on the cities that we now see being hit hardest. And the special requirements for this job listing by the CDC include knowledge in areas such as applied epidemiology, emergency preparedness and response, and emerging infectious diseases. Now, we shouldn't be surprised that the CDC had advanced knowledge of this, since the CDC also had advanced knowledge of the measles outbreak hysteria in Disneyland, which preceded the introduction of the vaccine mandate law in California, known as SB 277. The pharmaceutical industry wrote the law, and they bribed California officials such as State Senator Richard Pan to be ready to introduce it once the media narrative created sufficient mass hysteria after the measles was deliberately released, seeded across Disneyland to infect children. No one died from the measles. There's almost no one who ever dies from the measles. But the media hysteria was coordinated to push for nationwide vaccine mandates. That was the goal of that entire program. So in the last years of the Obama administration, genetically engineered biological weapons that were in the possession of U.S. universities were allowed under Obama to be sold to China. China then released these samples either on purpose or inadvertently. You can choose what version of history you wish to believe. But one way or another, this was all planned. Perhaps the plan was to put this weapon into the hands of the Chinese, knowing that their BSL-4 biohazard labs did not have sufficient protections to stop the release of this bioweapon, given that those same labs had experienced multiple accidental releases of SARS-CoV-1 over the previous decade. So perhaps, this is just a theory, who provided China the engineering technology and the samples so that China could fail to contain it? And the answer to that is the Obama administration and the death science industry that deals in genetically modified weapons and vaccines. They knew that the release of the coronavirus in China would not be able to be contained. They knew that because, well, they helped build it. They knew that the coronavirus had a very high transmissivity rate. In other words, it was highly infectious, and when combined with the extremely high international mobility of modern human civilization, they knew it would come to the United States. And they knew that once that happened, they could then funnel billions of dollars into the drug companies and the vaccine industry. And that was the goal from the start, to direct public money into these corporations and to make the CDC the hero of this story. But in order to accomplish that, the CDC had to make sure that the virus spread across America at an unprecedented scale. And how did they accomplish that? They deliberately botched the diagnostic testing kits that they released in early February. By mid-February, it became obvious that the kits did not work. So the CDC managed to delay the necessary surveillance and testing for coronavirus in the United States by nearly 1 month. While other countries were testing, like South Korea, and doing a very good job of aggressive surveillance, contact tracing, and selective isolation and quarantining of high-risk individuals, the United States was testing no one. This phenomenon became known as don't test, don't tell, a term that I actually coined in a podcast in February. Don't test, don't tell became the method by which the virus spread across America positioning the CDC to get emergency funding for the vaccine industry, for the pharmaceutical industry, and for itself. And sure enough, that's exactly what happened. Signed by the president, a large cash infusion into the pharmaceutical industry and into the coffers of the very same CDC that probably had a hand in engineering this entire outbreak in the first place, just like they did with measles in California. Now, that doesn't mean this pandemic isn't real. People are dying all over the world right now, and millions will likely die before humanity gets a grip on this. This could lead to the fall of finance as we currently recognize banking institutions today. This could lead to economic collapse. It could lead to failed nation states. And that's why I believe that the globalists behind this have truly gone too far. I think even they did not know what this was about to unleash. When they tried the measles scare in Disneyland, they told themselves it wasn't powerful enough. They didn't have enough deaths. And they use deaths, especially deaths of children, to get what they want, whether it's gun control or to try to censor conservatives. They knew that they needed a large number of deaths in order to finally push a vaccine mandate. And so they went to the most aggressive biological weapon system that they could dredge up out of the death science freezers of the BSL-4 laboratories and universities. And they found this coronavirus, a combination of MERS and SARS and HIV, with multiple receptor sites, rapid mutation, natural selection in the world of virology, sure to hit humanity with multiple waves, with different mutations, almost impossible to stop because of its long asymptomatic incubation period, during which carriers are highly infectious to others. This was the weapon that they chose because they wanted more money for the vaccine industry. Greed is what brought us the coronavirus. This did not come from the world of random mutations in nature or a seafood market in Wuhan. This came from the dark, twisted minds of the vaccine industry, the pharmaceutical industry, the genetic engineering, death science industry, and the globalists who have long wanted to exterminate most of the human population. There is no amount of suffering and death that is too much for them to witness as long as they gain profits and power. They are the vaccine industry. They are the pharmaceutical industry. And you notice that no one in Washington, D.C., not even the president, is telling people, hey, right now would be a great time to take some vitamin C, to grow a home garden. Now would be a great time to stop eating junk food, to improve your healthy habits, maybe even take some antiviral herbs that have a broad spectrum of efficacy that are safe and affordable and readily available to the American public today. That message has been silenced because the only message you'll hear now is, Big Pharma, please save us. Oh, vaccine, please save us. Oh, CDC, please come save us. And the advisors to President Trump, like Dr. Fauci, are the very same people who have funneled hundreds of millions of taxpayer dollars into the death science industry that created these monstrous, deadly biological weapon strains that are now threatening the very existence of human civilization as we know it today. The world, in fact, has reached a breaking point of greed, where greed drives everything. Greed and destruction have driven this agenda from the very start. And there's nothing they won't do to make sure they get more money while more people die. In fact, the mass death, the fear, the terror, the media hysteria is all part of their agenda to take more money from the world and leave you dead in the process. That is the vaccine industry. That is the CDC. And that is why they are the enemy of humanity. And that's why they must be stopped.